Now, KSBW Weather Plus with Jim VanderZwan.
A little morning mist, the rest was blue skies, sunshine, a beautiful day, storms to the north. Gaze upon these nice temperatures. 72 in Santa Cruz today, where for quite a while now, a fellow by the name of Ronald McDonald has been the official National Weather Service volunteer observer there in Santa Cruz. Today, Bob Benjamin for the Weather Service went over there, gave him a pin and a certificate for 35 years of service. And we've been talking to him for almost 30 years here at KSBW. Congratulations, Ron. Job well done. 68 Seaside in Monterey, 70 in Carmel by the Sea. You can't do that in July, you know. Fog mixed out, pretty darn nice. Getting a few 40s, though, in the valleys particularly. 74 in Salinas and in Greenfield, 73 in Gonzales and King City. Everybody pretty close. Nothing too hot, nothing too cool, ranging from 72 to 74 in the Santa Clara Valley as well. Gorgeous day if you missed it. 51 in Tahoe, 20 degrees warmer in Fresno and Bakersfield today, and another 10 for Palm Springs, 60s along the Southern California coast. So we're still doing pretty good. And from Phoenix all around the bottom end of the country, still plenty of 70s and 80s. 60s and 50s, New York and Chicago, get back here in Denver, never got above freezing. It's down to 24 degrees there right now. They had a bunch of snow today. Meanwhile, rain was still the factor in the Mid-Atlantic, the Ohio Valley, a couple of flurries in the Great Lakes, nothing that stuck on the ground, but boy, there got the plows out and everything around Denver and parts of Colorado. All this blue that you see is snow, the green and the red and the yellows, that's pretty much rain. Staying out of the hair of St. Louis, though. I don't think they're going to see much tonight, but they'll probably get a few passing showers for the World Series. Meanwhile, up to the north, front pretty much fizzled out by the time it got past Portland, so that was the end of that story. We'll have to wait a little longer. High pressure holding on here. Upper-level trough will put some wet weather from about Dallas on up into Oklahoma and parts of the mid-Mississippi River Valley, and also some rain working up in the New England states tomorrow that may cause a couple of flight delays. But for us, nothing much out of the Pacific yet. Storm track way too far north. Got high pressure backed up with a little high pressure at the surface, and that means offshore flow. Cools off, though, at night, what with less moisture in the air, down into the 40s, but no frost on the pumpkin yet. Highs will pick up into the 60s and 70s. We'll do it again for another day. We'll cool it off. You can see that wind comes out of the east to southeast, the Salinas Valley, and then a little bit of westerly breeze, so it won't get into the 90s and 80s this time of year. Days are just too short now, what with only 10 hours or so of daylight, so we can't get it quite that warm. But this is pretty good weather. Everybody seems to like this. Upper 60s and 70s around the San Francisco Bay Area, mostly mid-70s around the Santa Clara Valley. But again, upper 30s to about mid to upper 40s in the morning. So you open up the door and that cold air hits you in the face. You'll go, it must be fall. And you'd be right, because it is. So we go with that, because Halloween is just around the corner. 60s and 70s around the Monterey Peninsula, Carmel Valley looking good. We'll figure on upper 60s to about low 70s around Santa Cruz tomorrow and call it a nice day. And again, that little bit of nip in the morning air. So we'll go with clear and cool. East to southeast winds run about 5 to 10 miles an hour, so that's pretty good. Sunny and mild tomorrow, just another gorgeous day if you don't mind. And for that matter, we'll go with that for Friday. Offshore flows hanging around and likely will over the weekend. But this time of year, like I say, nothing terribly hot, but a lot of mid-70s to low 80s for the valleys. Might see a couple of high clouds Sunday, but nothing that you could call a temperature trend here. We just give or take a couple of degrees. Likewise on the coast. At this point, we'll keep a fog out. As to what happens next week, it's dicey. Beyond about Wednesday, some of the computer models keep a high-pressure ridge in. Another one brings a trough in here that could bring us a little rain. So that's still a ways out. We're going to just keep an eye on that over the coming days and see what happens. Because usually once you get to October, you start looking for wet. We had a little already.
Yeah, early a little
in the month,
bit.
As you know, just in fact, the hills are starting to green up already. Yeah. You know, just boom, like that. And so are the weeds. Boom, up they come. But right now we're looking okay. Maybe we'll get enough snow to start skiing around Thanksgiving, but that's still a ways away.
We've had some beautiful weather, and it's going to change. It's going to happen eventually.
It's going to happen. But this fall is feeling real good.
Very nice.